is 1838. The place, Central India. This is the indomitable fortress of Jhansi, a free and independent native state. Ancient bastion in a changing world, its weathered walls jealously guard time-honored traditions, defying intrusion in its way of life or in its rule. At this time, the throne is vacant. The late Maharaja has died without an heir. Four claimants await the decision of the ruling paramount power in India, the East India Company, whose envoy even now approaches the palace, bearing the tidings which will proclaim one of them king. Here is the power behind the throne. The Rajguru, guardian and custodian of its sacred independence. In 40 years of selfless devotion, he has labored untiringly to protect it from schemers. This is a man who would not count any sacrifice too great in its service.
And congratulate you, Your Highness.
Thank you, Colonel Sleeman. And you, Sadashiv.
Article 6. It is agreed by and between the parties to this treaty that the sovereign state of Jhansi shall cede to the East India Company territories yielding an average income of 227,458 company rupees yearly for the protection of its sovereignty and the upkeep of the necessary military forces. That all men serving in the Jhansi army shall be absorbed in the newly created occupation force.
Thank you, my dear. Thank you.
To our friendship, Your Highness.
The East India Company. They have sent their officer.
I sincerely hope this treaty will bring
prosperity to the state of Jhansi. Your Highness, I bid you good day.
Company acknowledges.
So you have signed. You dared to without my consent?
But Gurudev, what else could I do? What else would you have me do? Look at the Emperor of Delhi, the Nawab of Oud, the Peshwa of Pune. What else could anyone do against the ever-increasing might of the East India Company?
I thought it was the best thing to do. So you advised him. And do you know why? Because he knows you are a widower. You are aging and have no children. And he is the next in line.
But Rajguru, I swear.
One more perjury. What's the difference? Gangadhar Rao, I have given 40 years of my life to the service of the throne. Yet you did not even consult me before you sold it for a mess of pottage. It is obvious I have lost my usefulness here.
No, Gurudev, you can't go. What would I do without your help and counsel?
There stands your counselor. Oh God, somewhere in the bounds of this vast country, there must be a savior for my beloved Jhansi. Guide thou my footsteps.
Those words still fresh upon his lips, he Rajguru set out upon his journey, a journey in the course of which he was to travel many states and to gaze upon many wondrous sights before his ideal would finally be translated into reality. From state to state he made his way, seeking a bride worthy of his quest, a queen worthy of Jhansi.
Wanted to come with us. Sorry, Manu, you can't come with us. This elephant is only for princes. If you want a ride, a donkey is good enough for you.
You wait to me. Gajra?
No, she's so fearless, you kill herself.
Same right.
I think they were very rude to you. But they are of royal blood, my child.
And what's wrong with my blood?
Indeed, I wonder.
Manu! Manu, my child! Are you all right?
I'm all right.
Thank God.
Thank him, Father. He's the one who saved me.
God bless you, sire.
Your daughter?
Yes, sire.
daughter of a poor servant of the Peshwa. She's very, very naughty, afraid of no one. She acts as though she was born in the Peshwa's palace. But even the Peshwa is fond of my men.
I think I should see your Peshwa.
Well, Rajguru, now that you've seen our Manu's horoscope, would you like to know it?
I have yet to see such a horoscope. Remarkable.
Yes?
Indeed, sire. There is courage, honor and glory. You are fortunate, Marpant.
I am, sire.
Yes, Marpant. For 4 years I have been trying to find a queen for Jhansi. And I think I've found her in your daughter.
It's an honor, Rajguru. But the king is nearly 50. And my Manu, why, she is not even 9.
This marriage is not like any other. It has nothing to do with the age of the bride or that of the groom. Your little Manu is destined to lead armies in the fight for the freedom of our country. Soon the peal of wedding bells will change into the clang of arms and clatter of hoofs.
If all this be true, I am twice blessed. Once for begetting such a daughter, and again for giving her away. But I am a humble servant of the Peshwa. I cannot say yes without my master's consent.
This marriage has our blessing, Murupant.
Of India, proud home of heroic people, men and women of the greatest power. Valour who preferred to live one day in freedom than 100 years in slavery. On the other hand, you will also learn of India's traitors, like Punya and Mir Jaffa, who in the selfish interest of their personal gains, helped to feed this tiny red spot representing the East India Company until it swelled to its present enormous dimensions. This is the last year of your education. And this year we shall devote to the study of the Bhagavad Gita. This book, my queen, will teach you how to live and how to die too. The Lord has said in the Gita, to labor you have the right, but not to the fruits thereof. An ancient custom of our country, a revered tradition of centuries, that at the end of their studies all pupils must pay dakshina to their guru and receive his blessings. Accordingly, His Highness the Maharaja has been graciously pleased to place at your disposal the choicest jewels of his realm, and if they be found inadequate, they have his command to make over to you the keys of the imperial treasury. The keys, Your Highness.
Sire, I am grateful to you for withholding nothing to make my offering worthy of any queen. But not all these, not all the wealth of our country, could settle my deep debt to my guru.
It is true, my queen. Knowledge is above all worldly values. Yet, the teacher must be paid.
He shall be paid, my lord. I am more than conscious of the services he has rendered me. Gurudev, you shall be paid, and my dakshina shall be my pledge. And this pledge shall prove to you that for the 10 years I have spent under your guidance, I am not unworthy of my counsel. At this historic moment, as a mark of my undying fealty, I ask you to accept this pledge. I make a vow to you today upon this royal sword to uphold my sacred trust as Queen of Jhansi and as a defender of this country. I hereby dedicate my life to this country, nor shall I cease to guard and protect it, its freedom, its integrity, its interest, even to the last drop of my blood if the need arise, deeming it the highest honor to which I could aspire. Gurudev, this pledge is my Guru Dakshina. I pray you to bless me, that I may live up to it.
My valiant queen, no teacher has been paid more lavishly.
Sawari!
new ballet with original music. The story of the tiger and the flame. I hope you like it.
May I?
Thank you. Let the play begin.
Very good indeed.
Thank you.
My lord, I have greatly enjoyed your work of art. I am honored.
This really is a tribute. My play is indeed a success. Yours.
These things take time.
Yes, sir. Not yet, sire.
Not yet, sire.
It is a boy, your highness, a prince.
It is a boy?
Henry Cecil Dowker. Be at ease.
Thank you, sir.
Tell me, Dowker, of all the world's wonderful places, what made you leave London for this godforsaken spot in India?
I love India, sir.
Oh, well, we all do, but still.
Have you been? I was born here, sir.
Here?
Yes, sir, in Bitur, where my father was Deputy Commissioner of the East India Company for over 7 years.
He's buried in Bitur. Then you must have known our young queen. She comes from Bitter, I believe.
Manu? I certainly know her. We were playmates. I hope to see her again.
She won't remember you. She isn't Manu anymore. There's nothing left of the little girl you knew. She's now Rani of Jhansi, headstrong, capricious, and hates the uniform we wear. She won't see you.
I think I'll try, if I may.
Of course, why not? But I should wait until after the Maharaja's birthday procession.
Certainly, sir.
Hello, Commander. We wish to congratulate him.
Mano.
Henry Dalker. How you have grown up.
I might say the same about you, Manu. I mean, Your Highness.
Tell me, Henry, where were you all these years?
In England, then I joined the army and volunteered for service in India. And here I am, back home again.
My lord, this is Henry, Lieutenant Henry Dalker. With Nana and Rao, he was my playmate at Bitur. A great friend then. A great friend still, I trust.
Your humble servant, Your Highness. You are welcome, Lieutenant. Tell me, are you interested in music and drama? Perhaps you'd like to accompany me to a dress rehearsal of my new ballet. Your Highness is very gracious, but I beg to be excused. I must report to my commanding officer within the hour. Oh, of course. My compliments to your commanding officer. If Your Highness permits, we'd like to call on the little prince.
We?
I got married before I came out here.
Our congratulations.
We shall be very happy to meet your wife. You must bring her to the farewell party we are giving Colonel Sleeman next week. Your Highness is most gracious.
Find out if the prince is better.
Your Highness, may I have the honor to present my wife, Doris? I'm delighted, my boy. You have excellent taste, if I may say so.
The king looks as though he's enjoying himself. But where is the Rani?
How is the prince?
He's better today, thank you. The doctors are with him now.
Shouldn't you be?
I know. But my place is here tonight. These things are important as well. It's the price one pays for being a king. Hello, Colonel.
With your permission, Your Highness.
friends. Pardon me this interruption to your gaiety. My little prince, Damodar Rao, is dead. Come in, gentlemen. Have you made all preparations for the adoption of our nephew?
We have, Your Highness. But it could wait. God willing, Your Highness will be well again.
We all wish and pray His Highness gets well again. But we can't take any chances, especially when we know how relentless is Lord Dalhousie's policy of annexation. If they try any such thing here, they will find it's not so easy.
We know, Gus. We leave Jhansi in safe hands. Still, Rajguru is right. We should give them no excuse. You may go, friends, and take immediate steps for the adoption of our four-year-old nephew, Anath Rao. He is to be renamed Damodar Rao. Hear me. See to it that the ceremony is carried out strictly according to administration and Hindu scriptures. Invite the political agent and all of the important officials to the ceremony. Let the Governor General be informed that Queen Laxmibai will be the regent during the minority of our adopted son. And then, let all the flags fly high. All the guns salute the new heir to the throne of Jhansi. We are glad the ceremony is over. And thank you, Major, for being present.
Your Highness is very kind.
We trust the papers will be forwarded to the Governor General immediately. With your recommendation, of course.
I'll do my best.
Thank you, Major. Thank you.
Pay your respects to your mother and father, child.
Out of my sight, you!
Don't think you can get away with it. The throne is mine. You heard me. It's mine, and if I don't get it, no one else shall.
Sadashiv, please. Your uncle is very sick.
I don't care. And you. I wish you were a man and better born.
Get out or I'll kill you with my...
My lord.
Calcutta, Major?
Not yet.
But the messenger is due any moment. You had better wait.
Oh, how long am I to wait?
There's no need for impatience. After all, the throne of Jhansi is vacant. And as usual, there will be a dozen claimants.
There is only one claimant whose right is unchallengeable. And that is myself.
That's what they all say. However, I consider Gangadhar Rao was pretty clever the way he managed the adoption when his own son died. And I am not at all sure if the treaty makes any distinction between a natural and an adopted son.
There is only one way to read the treaty. Gangadhar Rao died without an heir. I fail to see where the adoption fits into it.
I don't know. But all the same, I wouldn't be surprised if the Governor General got sick and tired of this unholy mess and ordered the annexation of Jhansi. With the adopted son, the old trouble would remain.
But Major, he's not yet been crowned.
Well, let us wait and see.
Hey, hey! Funker, funker!
Sadashiv Rao is a traitor, Your Highness. I heard what he said myself.
We have ourselves to blame. We should have gone ahead with Damodar Rao's coronation and not looked to Calcutta for approval.
Nothing is lost yet, Your Highness. We still have time. We must proceed with the coronation immediately.
Yes, Rajguru. Commence the preparations.
In accordance with the cherished desire of His Highness the late Maharaja, and in pursuance of the command of the Queen Regent, we are here to witness the coronation of Prince Damodar Rao. Panditji, you may proceed with the ceremony.
From the Right Honourable Lord Dalhousie, dealing with Damodar Rao's adoption.
After the ceremony, the Queen will be pleased to consider it. Panditji, apply the Raj Tilak.
This is outrageous. I protest.
General. The Queen is in audience now.
Order of His Excellency the Governor General in Council. The dispute over the throne of Jhansi between the four-year-old Damodar Rao and Sadashiv Rao, the nephew of the deceased Maharaja. The Governor General in Council hereby dismisses both claims to the throne of Jhansi. In the interests of peace and order, and in the greater interest of the people of Jhansi, it is the full and complete annexation.
I will never give up my Jhansi. Once I took a vow here at this very place that I would defend my country's freedom to the last breath of my life. It shall be so. Tell your Governor General, I will never give up my Jhansi.
Ghulam Ghaz Khan, you are responsible for the safety of Major Ellis. Ramchandra Rao, you will take care of the prince.
Bless me, Mother. Give me strength to avenge this wrong, to redeem my pledge. No, no, Rajguru. Not even you can stop me.
Do you understand what that means?
I know, but I don't care.
You are a brave queen, but be also a wise queen. This mad rush will lead you nowhere.
Words, words, all words. For years you trained me to be a soldier, taught me to love my country and fight for its freedom. And now you stand there and tell me to be a wise queen. But where is the queen? I am not the queen. The king is not the king. There is no kingdom anymore. And the throne you have worshipped all your life, where is that throne?
Where it always has been. And I have never ceased to worship it. You shall remain our queen, and the king shall be our king. Give me your sword.
My sword?
Yes. This sword shall be your call to arms, and it shall raise a storm in which the mightiest power shall be caught and shaken down to its deepest roots. And then when you come out to fight, the whole country will be behind you.
And if you fail?
Do not forget, my queen, what the Lord has said. To labor you have the right, but not to the fruits thereof. Whether we succeed or fail, triumph or perish, your people will always remember that you were the first to draw your sword against aggression. And as long as the fight for freedom lasts, the name of the valiant Queen of Jhansi shall inspire them with courage and fortitude to carry on the war of independence till your country is free. So, gentlemen, we are all agreed upon our plan of action. Now it is up to us to see it through.
The people of Delhi have always given a good account of themselves. They shall not disappoint their country in its dire need.
Nor shall the brave Marathas be found wanting in courage and strategy.
You will find Awadh ready to the last man.
I shall answer for Bihar.
I am not a ruler, but I shall do what I can from every corner of Hindustan. And by God, it shall not be negligible.
And now, my illustrious friends, as for our emblem, I suggest that we use bread and a red lotus. If there is one language which the masses cannot fail to understand, it is the language of bread. And the lotus stands for our ancient culture.
Excellent! Excellent!
Remember, gentlemen, Sunday, the 31st of May, 1857.
Thus, with the dethroned princes pledged to fight for their rights, was born what is historically known as the League of the Lotus. Secret meetings were held all over the country, and an insidious incitement to revolt rippled under the surface for four long years. Religious instincts were inflamed by stories circulating among troops under British command that the newly introduced greased cartridges they had to bite before firing were smeared with the blood of the cow and the fat of the pig. Such measures were more than effective. The clamor for revolt grew. Plans were laid. The people waited for the fatal date. In faraway Jhansi, the Rani cautioned against any hasty action that might jeopardize success. But 9 weeks early, there occurred an incident that was to change the course of history. In a small cafe, a dancing girl entertained a group of sepoys. Among them was a young hothead named Mango Pandey, with whom she was in love. She mocked him for wearing the hated greased cartridges. Whereupon, in a moment of frenzied excitement, he loaded his rifle with one of the hated cartridges and fired, killing his commanding officer. Mango Pandey was executed, the soldiers disarmed, and the spark ignited that was to set all India ablaze.
Your Highness. Under great difficulties, I have come to you to seek your help.
Seek my help? Captain, you forget. I am not the Queen.
The mutineers are after our blood. The very guns meant for our protection are being aimed at us. As soldiers, we are prepared to die fighting. But it's for our women and children that I seek your help.
Though a disarmed woman myself, I will give my protection to your women and children. Send them here to me, by the underground passage.
This noble gesture I shall never forget.
Kashi! Call out my guards and see that Captain Gordon is escorted back to the Star Fort in safety.
It's already morning. Captain Gordon has not yet returned from the Queen.
He shouldn't have gone at all. It's foolish to expect any help from her. She'd never give it to us anyway.
And even if she agreed, she might change her mind.
She might say yes, just to lure us out of the fort.
Darling, you should know better. She may refuse to give us help, but she's not the one to deceive us.
Between the two of them, I'd rather choose the mutineers. There is a chance.
Yes. We can't hold out any longer. No ammunition, no food, no water.
Let's give ourselves up to the mutineers. After all, they're our men. They should have some feeling for us.
All right. If that's how you feel, I'll go.
Tyrann Fort! Men! Get ready with your ropes! We need them!
Last time, Major, open the gate and come out on one condition, that you will let us pass unharmed to Saga. I'll guarantee your safety, Major. You will be responsible for your men. Yes, upon my word of honor.
Before he could even reach the Star Fort, he was shot down. And our guards? They died defending him. Not one escaped. Where are the British women and children? They took them to Dokanbag. And what? They killed the men, women, and children. Oh, God.
And if you do not need us, we go to Delhi. Give us money, or we loot Jhansi.
Silence! If money is all you are fighting for, here. Take this. And if any one of you dares harm my Jhansi, I shall have him executed as a traitor and a criminal.
The Ulhas belongs to!
Ah!
And country to!
Ah!
And the rule to!
Ah!
Gentlemen, General Securos.
Sit down, gentlemen. A
according to the military plan, for the reconquest of all the territories from the Himalayas to the Vindhyas in the hands of the mutineers, the armies under my command will advance towards Jhansi. Laxmibai, the woman who likes to call herself Queen of Jhansi, shall pay dearly for the massacre in Jochenberg.
I think Sadashiv hasn't told you all, sir.
No? Perhaps you would like to add something.
I was also there, sir. My escape was miraculous. But I know the Queen had nothing to do with the massacre. She did all she could to restrain that murderous crowd.
Perhaps Lieutenant Dowker could explain why this Queen, as he chooses to call her, gave away her pearl necklace worth more than 125,000 rupees to those very men whose hands are running red with the innocent blood of British men, women and children. But sir...
That's enough. Brigadier Stewart, you will proceed via Jabalpur, suppress the uprising there, and join us, let us say, 2 weeks from today at Jhansi.
Henry.
Lieutenant Henry Dowker, an officer of the British Armed Forces, an envoy of General Sir Hugh Rose.
Well, officer, let us hear what you have to say.
From the commanding officer of the British Armed Forces, Central Command, to the self-styled Queen of Jhansi. Madam, we are now possessed of strong evidence establishing your complicity in the Indian mutiny. The brutal deeds of your people far surpass all known atrocities. You are personally responsible for the cold-blooded murder of British men, women and children, whose innocent blood calls for a prompt and just retribution. I therefore demand your immediate and unconditional surrender with your 14 principal accomplices. If you fail to give yourselves up within the next 48 hours, I shall march upon Jhansi with all the forces my command and capture you and your accomplices.
Enough, officer! Go back to your general!
General, the letter is addressed to us!
Compliments of the commander.
Lieutenant, you will tell Sir Hugh Rose that we shall not disappoint him. We shall come to pay our compliments. And with us shall be all the 14 officers whom he has kindly invited, and many more whom he has forgotten to mention. As for the place, we prefer meeting him on the field of battle. And about these, my general will reply. Just a moment, Lieutenant. For your commander. Stand him in good stead when he runs out of ammunition.
You haven't changed, Manu.
of Jhansi. This is not your queen speaking to you, but a fellow soldier who deems it a great honor to fight beside you. They are many, we are few, but that will not discourage us. Numbers have seldom decided battles. I hear their guns roar. Let our guns roar too. We shall give them a warm welcome.
Allahu
Allah!
Of our peace. Let Ganga speak with such a voice that will strike them dumb.
At your orders, Rani. In the name of Allah.
Guns are playing havoc with our men. They're pinned down completely. A couple of days more of this, and I won't have a man left on his feet. Sadashiv, you have spent all your life in Jhansi. You should be able to help us.
General, change the position of your guns. Hide them behind the temples. She dared not blow up the temples, even if she did give such orders. The gunners would refuse to obey them.
Not a bad idea. Maybe it will work. Change the gun position to the right behind the temples.
Very good, sir.
What is it?
Sir, that rebel Tatius coming with 20,000 men to relieve the Queen.
The devil take him. He couldn't have chosen a worse time.
Tatius could not have chosen a better time. If we can hold on two more days, we shall have the enemy at our mercy.
Brigadier Stewart, take 2,000 men. I think 2,000 of our well-trained soldiers should be enough for Tatia's rabble. And proceed north-northeast to meet him. Keep him engaged till victory comes to us.
have been causing destruction everywhere. What has happened to our guns? Why are they silent? You must do something.
I can't, Your Highness. To get at them, I have to blow up the temple.
Then blow them up. Our country above our religion.
If that is your command, Your Highness, here goes Gangarj. Rao! Karakbili! Ramba! Gagandur! Jai Hanuman!
Well done, Ghal. I am proud of you. Jhansi is proud of you.
My queen, I do not deserve that honor. I did my duty, that is all.
As I was saying, Sadashiv, this temple idea of yours has done us no good. 6 days and 6 nights wasted, hundreds of our men killed, ridiculous.
If I have your assurance, Sir Hugh Rose, that I am getting the throne of Jhansi...
Of course, you will have the throne. But after all, you seem to forget that to reach your throne, my men must take the fort first, fight for every inch of it. Sadashiv, you're a clever man. There must be a way to avoid some of the bloodshed. But this time it had better work.
I'll do my best. I'll lead your men to the Orca Gate. I have my friends there. Tonight, at 12, when you mount guard at the Orca Gate, look out for the signal.
As you command, sire.
I give you this to seal the pact. And when I get the throne, you will be the richest man in Jhansi.
Again. No, no. This time I will not yield to you.
All is not lost, Your Highness. Fortune sometimes frowns, sometimes favors.
I have heard that before. You need not go through that all over again. The best of our men killed. Our trusted friends dead. The city in flames. What is left for me? Except the funeral pyre.
There is no sense in this suicide. Desperation does not lead anywhere. As long as there is hope, there is life.
Hope? You see these dead men? Hear those shrieks? And still you talk of hope.
Yes, there is a single hope. Go to Gwalior. Nana and Rao are waiting there with their forces. Together you can strike and take back Jhansi. Make a fresh bid for freedom.
Jhansi. Freedom. You think it is possible? You win again. I will go. But this time you are coming with us.
No, Your Highness. My place is here beside the throne. We do our duty. You, yours, I, mine. Hurry, my queen. Go. Go before it is too late.
Goodbye, my friend. My guru. We shall not meet again. But wherever you be, you will know your pupil paid her guru Dakshina with her blood.
I was not wrong about you, Manu. God bless you.
At the north gate. We will have to pay dearly for it. Dalker, take the best horse, take the best riders, and bring back that woman dead or alive.
Yes,
any news from Kalpi about Rajguru?
We were 24 when we left.
I hope the others were only captured.
I hope they were killed. All of them.
Osha!
Your Highness, you must reach Kalpi! Going with her highness.
My place is here with you.
I'm sorry. I have to do this, my queen. Gangadhar Rao.
Your
What have I done to you, Henry?
Don't be sad, Manu. We had to do our duty. I would have done the same for my country, for England. It's better this way.
Henry, Henry.
He survived the attack at the fort, the massacre at Yarkinbag. I sent him to his death.
The Queen of Jhansi has reached Balia and joined Tatya and Rao.
He has? That woman will give us no rest. Captain, we march upon Gwalior immediately.
Come in. Come along, Manu. We are being entertained.
I am surprised, Rao, that you could degrade yourself so.
What's wrong with you? Can't I have a little pleasure sometimes without your interference?
I am sorry if it hurts. But I cannot see you waste your time. You so well to strengthen your position. Tomorrow it may be too late. Even as you sit on it, your throne is shaking under you.
My throne is my concern, and I shall do as I wish with it.
Rao, please understand. Do not throw away this opportunity. Now is your time to prepare and be ready to repulse the attack which is bound to come.
If you were as wise as you think you are, you would still be in Jhansi. And not here. On with the music. On with the dance.
Thank you.
forces are starting to take up their positions, Your Highness.
We will not give them the time for that. My soldiers, our first objective must be to override their guns. Veer Singh, you will attack from the right. Kamal Singh, you attack from the left.
To encircle her, immediately the cavalry charge is over. That should seal her fate.
Thank you. My queen, who has done this awful thing.
सकते इन चोलों को शासन के अभिमानी स्वर्ग सिधारी वो वीरात्मा देकर ये संदेश जान सभी को प्यारी है पर जान से प्यारा देश
धन्य धन्य
अमर है झांसी